Another step to getting people back to the moon. NASA resumed testing today for the Artemis 1 mission at Kennedy Space Center. West 2 Scott Heidler is live there for us right now. And Scott, how's the testing going?
Well, it started off very well, but about 2 hours ago, we started to see some snags, one with a hydrogen fuel leak and another with a pressure issue. But according to NASA, this is why you have pre-flight testing. NASA likes to call it their mega moon rocket, and Artemis 1 is back out on launch pad 39B for a wet dress rehearsal that kicked off early Monday morning. The testing was called off in April due to problems pumping in the 733,000 gallons of fuel into the Space Launch System Rocket Stack, or SLS. But just before 12 noon Monday, the fueling of liquid nitrogen and liquid oxygen had already passed the point of the last wet dress rehearsal before it was called off, and the SLS was rolled off the pad to fix several issues. It returned to pad 39B on June 6th.
But they want to check out these systems. This is very important. We don't want to get to the point where there's an actual countdown for the actual launch, and there are these types of ground support equipment and little problems that keep cropping up.
The critical pre-flight test runs through the entire launch process, stopping just short before ignition. SLS is a more complex system than what we regularly see from SpaceX.
We saw three launches in 3 days with the Falcon 9, but that's overall a much simpler vehicle. There's millions of parts here that are working together. There's a whole number of people on the ground. There's ground support equipment.
SLS will fly a lunar mission later in the year, an uncrewed one, orbiting but not landing on the moon. And then after that, following that, there'll be a crewed mission with the same objective. A few years after, that will be Artemis 3, where astronauts will land on the moon. Reporting live at the Kennedy Space Center, Scott Heidler, West 2 News.